How do pilots know the weather en route and a destination? Let me tell you all about aviation weather as part of our pre-flight preparation with the significant weather charts and routine weather information such as the METAR, TAF and ATIS. Knowing the weather in advance is very important to ensure a safe flight. When we expect bad weather at destination, we will take extra fuel so that we are prepared to hold and wait for the bad weather to pass. In all cases, also with good weather, we have a destination alternate if for any reason we cannot land at our destination airport. For pilots, the most important weather details are the wind, visibility, precipitation, clouds, and temperature. For the en route phase of flight, we look at significant weather charts during our pre-flight preparation. On the chart for low altitude, you will find details about icing, turbulence, thunderstorms, mountain waves, and different kinds of precipitation. On the high altitude chart, you also find details about turbulence and icing, but also about jet streams and the tropopause. Besides the en route weather data, it is very important to know the weather at our departure airport, destination airport, and alternate airport. The current weather is provided in a half-hourly bulletin called METAR, Meteorological Terminal Aviation Routine Weather Reports. Let's have a look at this METAR from Verona. It may all seem a bit difficult, but you will see after explanation that it's quite easy to understand. The first letters, Lima India Papa X-ray, is the airport identifier, the ICAO code for Verona Airport. And it shows at what time the report was made. In this case, it was made on the 5th of the month at 12:20 UTC. Next is the wind, coming from 340 degrees, so north-northwesterly wind, at 13 knots. Now we're going to look at the visibility. This is given in meters. RA stands for rain. Now let's have a look at the clouds. What we want to know is how much clouds are covering the sky and at what altitude. If we divide the sky above us in 8 parts, we can identify how much of the sky is covered. If the clouds are covering 1 to 2 parts, it's few clouds. 3 to 4 parts is scattered clouds, 5 to 7 parts is broken, and 8 parts is overcast. For the altitude, we should add 2 zeros to the given number. So in this case, we have 5 to 7 parts of clouds covering the sky at 4,000 feet. Next up is the temperature and the dew point. The temperature is 10 degrees and the dew point is 2 degrees Celsius. The temperature is important to know, as with low temperatures we may need to use our anti-icing methods for the engines, wings and tail. When the temperature is close to the dew point, we expect fog or mist. Finally, the QNH is reported at 1002 hectopascal. If you're curious to find out what is the QNH, have a look at my other educational video about how pilots determine the airplane altitude. For various weather, there are many different abbreviations. Some abbreviations can be used together. Why don't we try? Can you find out the meaning of the following abbreviations? You may want to pause the video because in a few seconds I will give you the answer. Did you get all the abbreviations right? Let me know in a comment below this video. I would love to know how well you did. Now let's have a look at the METAR of Palermo Airport. Do you recognize something different? Now no visibility and clouds are reported. When the visibility is more than 10 kilometers and there are no clouds below 5,000 feet or minimum sector altitude, whichever is higher, and there is no current or forecasted significant weather such as precipitation, it will be reported as cavoque, ceiling or clouds, and visibility okay. Whilst the METAR gives information about the current weather, the TAF gives a weather forecast. The data is quite similar, but let's have a look at this TAF from Venice Airport. First, the identifier, Lima India Papa Zulu, Venice Airport. Time of publishing is the 5th of the month, at 0500 UTC. As this is a weather forecast, we are interested in the validity of this report. It shows that it is valid from the 5th of the month at 0600 UTC until the 6th of the month at 1200 UTC. Next is the wind. It shows a wind from 040 degrees north-northeasterly at 20 knots, but with gusts, sudden moments of stronger winds of 30 knots. The visibility is 10 kilometers or more, which is indicated by 9999. And we expect few clouds at 3000 feet. Next up is a temporary change, lasting for periods of 30 minutes or more, but not longer than 1 hour, and it does not cover more than half of the total indicated period. In this case, the tempo is valid between 0600 and 0900 UTC. A thunderstorm will pass over the airfield between that time frame. Becoming indicates a gradual change of weather over a period and will remain that way for the rest of the TAF validity period. In this example, the specific weather will arrive between 16 and 18 UTC, the wind will calm down to 12 knots, still from 040 north-northeasterly direction. When we are in the air and are approaching the destination, the weather may have changed since the last METAR that we received on the ground. Therefore, when en route, we can listen to a frequency where the ATIS can be heard. This is the Automatic Terminal Information Service. Let's listen to the ATIS of Turin Airport.
This is Turin, ATIS arrival and departure information Alpha. At 1220, type of approach, ILS Yankee, runway in use, 36, transition level, 75, wind. Touchdown, 050 degrees, 3 knots. Direction variable between 030 and 160 degrees. Stop and variable 3 knots. Visibility, 10 kilometers or more. Clouds, few 8,000 feet. Temperature, 15 degrees. Dew point, minus 02 degrees. QNH. 1003 head to Pascal. You have received ATIS information Alpha.
Besides the weather, the ATIS may also give information about the airport. For example,
wind shear runway 28. Runway conditions. Damp. Airport information. Work in progress. Operational information. Taxiway 90 and kilopost. Wind threshold 10 and runway visual range. Runway 10 not available.
In most weather situations, the airplanes can land with no difficulty. Airplanes aren't made of sugar, so they won't melt with some rain. For pilots, it's most important to be proactive and to be aware of the weather to be expected. Thank you for watching. If you have any questions, let me know in the comments below. I'm more than happy to answer them. As always, if you liked the video, put a thumbs up, and for more educational videos, have a look at my channel. Feel free to subscribe. More awesome videos are coming up.